In this video, you will see how to link starter kit IO-Link Master with Siemens S7-1200 PLC. So there are various steps involved if you want to link your IO-Link Master with the PLC. Let's see what are these various steps. So the first step is you have to connect your IO-Link Master with the sensor, power supply and the PLC. So if you have seen my first video, you might have an idea how to link all these together. So if you see on my table, we have this IO-Link Master which is connected to Profinet to my Ethernet switch, and I have a power supply and I have my sensor already connected. So this is the step one, you have to follow it, but we will see more in detail about the connections. The step two is you have to download the GSD file for the IO-Link Master and you have to install it in the Siemens TI portal, because I'm using Siemens TI portal to program my PLC. And then we will configure this IO-Link Master and we will put some parameters in the PLC. And the step three is we have to make a logic as per the requirement and we will download that logic in the PLC, and finally we will see the sensor readings in the PLC. So let's explore these steps in detail, and I will be showing you a practical demonstration on my table with the Siemens TI software. So the step one, if you see in this video, we have an Ethernet switch. So I'm not linking my IO-Link Master directly to the PLC, I have an Ethernet switch in between. Because I have my HMI connections, my computer connections, so I need multiple ports. So probably if you don't have an Ethernet switch, you can connect your IO-Link Ethernet cable directly to your PLC. But in case if you have an Ethernet switch, you can make a connection like that. So you will see Profinet switch is connected by a wire. This Profinet port is connected by a wire to my Ethernet switch. This is powered with 24 volts and one of the ports is going to the sensor. This is we have already seen in the first video. The interesting thing is about the IP addresses. You have to assign the IP addresses to your IO-Link Master and to your PLC as well. And then you have to make sure these both IP addresses are in the same subnet. So once you have made this connection, once you have done this connection, then we'll proceed to the further steps. So the step 2 is you have to download a GSD file for this IO-Link Master AL1100. Now what is a GSD file? GSD file is provided by the manufacturer when you have to define the Profinet or Profibus interface of the device. So GSD file is very important in the projects where you want to link your products with another Profinet device, for example a PLC. So we have to download this file. So this file you can find in this link, and this link is also given in the video description. So if I show you have already opened this browser with this link. So when you open this link, you will come to this browser and then you have to search your IO-Link Master. If you're using another version, you can select from here, but the one which I'm using is GSTM, TML AL1100 IO. So I can download it from here. If you have another version, you can download the versions from these links, and these are the open source. So I have already downloaded my GSD file in this folder. Alright, so this was the second step 2.0. Now the next step is we have to install this file in Siemens TIA. So let's see how we can do that. So I will open my Siemens TIA over here. And I have to go to options and you go to manage general station description file. So this is the option here you will see on your software. Just click on that. And then you have to provide the source path. So my path is already given. Otherwise, you just click on this button here and give your path. And in my case, the path is here. This is the path of my GSD file. Click OK. So this path is defined and you will see the GSD file which are in the folder. So just select this one and click install. So this will take a few seconds and it will install the GSD file in your Siemens TIA. Once it's complete, you have to click on close. So it will update your hardware catalog, because this is a hardware file. So this will be updated in your hardware catalog once you go to the device configuration. So let's wait for a few seconds, and now if you go to your device and networks, in your hardware catalog you will find the GSD file already inside the subfolders. So let's see what is the next step. After installing the file, the next step says you have to drag your AL1100 in your networks. So let's see how we can do that. So in this case, if you are unable to find the required hardware file, just click search and put your module number. So I put it should be 1100, and you have to make sure you put the correct number. So once I put the correct number, I have my file here because I just installed it. So just drag it and bring it here. Now in this case, you will notice it says not assigned. This is a Profinet name which is not assigned and it is not linked to my PLC. The next step is just click on this button. This is the small button which highlights the Profinet, but it is not fully filled like this one because this is not linked to any network. So just select this one and bring it and drag it here. So this is now linked to your PLC, and the Profinet name is also predefined. If it is not defined, you just right click on it and click assign a new IO controller, and this will be linked. So I have to make sure it is not assigned. It should be assigned with some controllers. So the step was to build the network. We just did that, and assign the network. We already did that. Now the next step is you have to assign the ports to your IO-Link master. So how we do that? To assign the ports, if you click here, you have this file. Just double click on this one and you get inside this hardware module. Now you'll go to the module, click on this one, and you'll find four ports. Just drag these four ports over here. So this will automatically define different ports. So the main ports of your IO-Link where the sensors are connected is number 12, 13, 14 and 15. These are the four ports, because we have four ports if you see in the hardware for my sensor. My sensor is connected to the first port, which is the port number 12. So now I have to put the value, I have to configure this port with this sensor. Now I know that my sensor is giving me some values and I have to also have some diagnostic information. So what I'll do is I'll go to IO-Link input, because this is just an input, it's not an output. I'll go to my input and select 2-byte, because I know my sensor is giving me 2-byte of information. So I'll go to my 2-byte and just drag it to my first port. So my first port is defined with IO-Link, which is the sensor, 2-byte of information, because this is giving me a range of from 3065 to 3200. So 2-byte is 16-bit information, which is good enough for my sensor readings. And plus PQI means one register is reserved for its diagnostic information. This is very important. So once you define the sensor hardware here, you will have its I address automatically, which is I68, 69 and 70. So two bytes for this information and 1 byte I70 for PQI. All right. So once this is defined, you have to check your other ports are not connected in the hardware. So what you have to do is you have to disable them, because you just can't leave it alone. So we have to define it. So you just drag this disable in all other ports like this. So now we have finally configured our hardware. Let's see what is the next step in our presentation. So we have done this step. We have got the IO addresses. And the next step is we have to download the configuration to PLC. So what I see here is, if we see my IP addresses, this is 192.168.1.1, which is conflicting with my PC IP address. If I see my PLC IP address, this is 192.168.1.102. So I have to go back to my presentation and check the IP addresses which I have configured already for my IO-Link. So if I go to my step 1, the IP address which I configured was 192.168.1.106. So I'll go back to my TIA and change the IP address. This step is very important, because if your IP address is conflicting with other devices, it will create some problem. So I will go offline and change the IP address to 106, press enter, and then I'll download it again. The IP address which was previously assigned to my IO-Link master was similar to my Ethernet router, so that's why it was creating some problems. So now I hope so everything would be okay. So now my device is running, it's online, and if you see the status in my network, you will see these green dots and everything is ticked, which means my configuration is okay. So you have to make sure these green ticks. And if you see in my IO-Link master, there is no red LED and this is blinking with orange LED here, which means it's successfully getting the values from the Profinet. So let's go back to my watch list again. In my watch table, let's go to online. And now you will see the values again. It's 289, the monitor value, and the distance is 18 centimeter. If you see the distance from here, it is having a value of 2064 with a distance of 159 and 158. So this is basically changing. The distance changes as the sensor moves. So we have finally configured our sensor to give us the raw value. And now we have to convert this raw value into some meaningful value, which is in centimeter. How we can do that? This we can do that in the PLC programming. So if you see my main program, I have this PLC program. In this PLC program, I'm using a scaling factor. A scaling function is defined in this calculate function. If I open this function, this is my logic. And this logic says maximum scale output minus minimum scale output multiplied by raw input minus minimum raw input divided by maximum raw input minus raw input plus minimum scale output. So this is minus minimum raw input plus minimum scale output. This is the formula I'm using, and my maximum scaled output is this one. If you see maximum scaled, I need 200 centimeters is my maximum scale. Minimum scale, I need 4 centimeter. Raw input is the raw input coming from the sensor. Maximum raw input is 3200, which the sensor gives me. Minimum raw input, which the sensor is giving me, 65, plus minimum scaled output. Minimum scaled output is 4. So this is the sensor scaling formula, and the output is going to IW72, which I defined for sensor in centimeter. Now, why I took IW68? If you go to my watch table, I'm getting the raw value in IW68, and this IW68 is coming from here. If you go to your AL1100 module, this is the sensor address starting with 68, and this is the input, and this is 2 byte, which is a word, so IW68. So I'll go back to my watch table. This is IW68, and now the third register is sensor diagnostic, which is IW70. Now this is very important. If you see here, we have some bits. So IW70, bit number 0 1 2 3 4 5, so bit 5 and bit 7. Generally, if I start from 0, 5th and 7 is true. Now if I go to my HMI, I want to show you, if I run my HMI again, my HMI is having some value. So this value, which says connected, this is connected because if you see these bits, I have took these bits here, which says this is the 5th and 7th bit, this is the 5th and 7th bit. So the 5th bit is, I'm taking it here. So this bit is true because of I70.5. So this bit says sensor IO link is connected. And the another bit, sensor measuring 70.7, says that sensor is measuring correctly. So if you see in the video, if I put the box next to the sensor, now this shows red. This is not a valid output, and your PLC also sometimes blinks with an error. Now, because the sensor is showing some values in raw, but you don't have to consider this value because it's not a valid output. Sensor is too much close to the object, and this gives an impression that sensor is dusty, sensor is dirty. So you have to make sure that your object should be more than or less than the ranges of the sensor. It should not be close to the minimum range, because this will be an error. It should not be far than the maximum range. So if the object is within the range of your sensor, everything looks okay. But when the object is too close, this gives an impression that sensor is dirty. So your bit get false here, measuring bit. Sensor IO link connected is the bit which comes from this part of the port. If this bit is green, it means this is connected perfectly fine. If there is some problem in the error, problem in the wire, or in the sensor, wire is loose or sensor is not working fine, this particular bit will be false. So this is how it configure, and you will have a diagnostic information from the sensor from this register. So what I'm doing is, I have defined some ranges in my PLC program. I have a minimum range and I have a maximum range. If I set my minimum range to 20 centimeter and maximum to 50 centimeter, now if my object is between this range, I will get the value. So this value says object in range, but it's not in range. That's why this is red, because my object is just 6 centimeter or 7 centimeter away. If I take it away, my object is still 19 centimeter, but my minimum range is 20. That's why it's not in range. So if I change my range to 10 centimeter, now my object is in range, because this is 19 centimeter. So this is how you can make any logic using this raw value and converting it into the centimeter value, and you can make your logic based on the algorithm. Alright, so the algorithm which I am using is very simple. First, I scale my input to the value in centimeter. Then I just use in range block and out range block to use some output bits. You can use your own logic. There could be many ways to define this logic, but this is all about how you read the values in the HMI via IO Link Master. Let's go back to the presentation and end up what we left with. So we have seen this part. Step 2 was completed, step 2.2 is completed, 2.4 is done, and finally we downloaded the configuration and we were reading the values. So this is all about IO-Link Master. Just to review it up, if you don't use IO-Link Master, your sensor will only give you the value if the object is present or not. And you can use this pin diagram to wire up your sensor. Like the pin number 1 is brown, you connect that to 24 VDC, pin number 3 is blue, you connect that to 0 volt, and pin number 4 is black, which is a PNP output, goes to the PLC. We have seen this example in my first video, in which we were just getting the high or false, or true or false, high or low value from the sensor. But in case if you are using an IO-Link, you have the value coming in analog range. So for example, in our case, if the value was 3 cm or in case sometimes 4 cm, depends upon how you calibrate your sensor, my value was getting is 65. When it was at the medium range, I will get a different value. When it is at the maximum range, I get this value. Now these values or different values are coming from the same wire which you are seeing here, the black wire. This is because of a new technology which is called SDCI, the Single Drop Digital Communication Interface technology. It reserves a memory bit for sending this information. If you are interested in reading more about this technology, you will find link in the description. We have a PDF file where you can study about this SDCI technology widely used in IO-Link. If you're convinced with this technology, it's the right time to buy IO-Link Master for your application and see minute by minute information for your sensors and actuators. If you are interested in buying this starter kit, we have a reduced price which IFM is selling it, and you can find this price on this link. This link is also given in the video description. So I hope I'll make more videos on this sensor and IO-Link technology. You can subscribe to this channel to have more videos. Have a nice time.